In this video demonstration, I will show you how you can localize your WPF application using ComponentOne Studio for WPF. Localization means translating your user interface into languages of different cultures or locales. There are many different scenarios when localizing a Windows application. In this demonstration, I will show you the basic two steps required to take advantage of the built-in localization feature of Studio for WPF. First, open your project settings and specify the published language of your application. The published language can be found on the Publish tab. Click Options and select Description. For example, I will choose Spanish. This will tell Visual Studio to package up resources for the specified language in the published output. When you install ComponentOne Studio for WPF, localized assemblies are included for each library for over 20 different cultures. A key in your registry will allow Visual Studio to find these resources automatically based on the published language. The second thing you need to do is set the current thread's culture in your code behind. This is typically done on application load. For example, here I am setting the current thread's culture to Spanish using the two-letter culture code ES. That's all you need to do to take advantage of the localization feature found in Studio for WPF. Run or publish your application and notice the ComponentOne controls are automatically translated based upon the published language and the current thread culture you just specified. When you publish your application, you will notice that only the necessary localized resources will be included in the output. Now, chances are that you will have additional text in your application that is not part of any ComponentOne control that you need localized. To localize additional parts of your application, you will need to create an additional resource file, like the ones installed with Studio for WPF, and add your own translations. For example, here I've added two resource files named strings and strings.es. It's important to follow the standard guidelines for naming localized resource files in order for the CLR to handle the localization. Strings will contain my default language, and strings.es will contain my Spanish translations. Add all of your strings and their translations to these files, and then in your application code, you will set the text at runtime by using the Resource Manager class. For example, here I am setting the text of my button to a specific key in my resource file. When you use the Resource Manager class, you do not have to specify the language or culture because the runtime will automatically retrieve the correct resource based on the current thread's culture. For more information on general localization tips and best practices, visit the WPF documentation on MSDN. For more information on Studio for WPF, visit www.componentone.com and download your free trial today.